Hello, crafty friends, it's Scrap and Craft Queen, and I wanted to come by and show you and do a tutorial on this cute pencil case that I saw, and it was inspired by a girl on Pinterest. I don't remember her name, but she inspired me to make one. She made it and it was super cute. You can put your pencils in here or erasers or whatever you want in there. And I thought it was super cute to make and share. And so yeah, so I'm going to go ahead and make one with you guys so that you can get inspired and make your own. Okay, so let's get started. So first of all, you're gonna need to cut out some felt, excuse me, and this one is 11 and a half by 8 is the felt piece, so this one is 11 and a half, and then I cut it at 6 and three quarters wide. Okay, I didn't trim the bottom though, just the side to 6 3/4. Okay guys, then you're gonna need to cut out these items. This is the horn, and you're going to need two ears with white felt. Then you're going to need the inner ears, and I have a template for it. And so yeah, so you cut out your pieces, and then you got your little cheekies, and then this is your eyelashes, and then you have your hair, your three pieces of hair, and then your mouth. Okay, and like I said, I do have the template, so if you're interested, I will try to put in the description box, but for some reason, every time I try to link something, it never works. So we'll see if I can link it. If not, I can send it to you by email, but I'll definitely try to link it and see if it works this time. So let's go ahead and put this cuteness together. Okay guys, so what I did was I folded in, well, first I did this. Hope I'm in camera, because sometimes for some reason I can't see if I'm in camera. But what I do was I used my fabric tack glue and I glued the top. Just put a little bit of glue, because this glue works really good on felt fabric. I didn't want to use my glue gun because sometimes it goes through the felt. So you're going to do about a half an inch fold right here. And you got to press down. I didn't press down, so here we go. Okay. So you press down and it'll stay. Okay. So then what I did on the top, the lady that inspired me to make it, she put her ears and horn on the back of the pocket, but I didn't really like that, so I kind of twisted it up a little bit. I put it on the inside, and then I just glued an extra piece of felt there to cover the inside of it. I think it looks better because you don't have the pieces hanging from here, so that's what I did. So I'm gonna do now is I'm going to glue my ears. Okay guys, so take your ear, put a little glue there, and you want to put it right about there, not too high, not too low, because you're gonna put your piece of felt there to cover that up. Okay, then you're gonna glue, oops, I'm running out of glue. You're gonna glue this one here. Okay, so I'm gonna glue this one in the center, and what I did was I put a little higher, so when I put my other piece here to cover this, it won't cover the pink. Okay, so let's do this. I'm going to glue my pink piece first. Okay, here we go. So then going to glue it here to this piece, I'm going to put it right here. Right there. Okay. So then I'm going to do my horn. Now the template of the horn, that's another thing. It's a little longer than this piece I am gluing. And I cut it down a little bit because when I glued it and I put it, for some weird reason, it shaked a lot up and down. It wasn't sturdy, okay? So I kind of brought it down a little bit more and I cut the horn a little shorter. Okay, guys, I'm gonna cover that. And then so from your piece that you have left from this side for when you trim it, you're going to cut just about a half an inch. I'm gonna cut about a half an inch. And then what I did, it never comes out perfect because I don't know. You hold it and it just moves, it's felt, so I don't battle with it. I just cut. So then I took and I just cut a small piece, like about a quarter, I would say. And I cut it. It's not gonna come out perfect, guys. I tried to cut it with my cutter and it wouldn't cut, so there you go. And then I just measured, I nipped it, and there we go. So all I did was took my glue, glued it there. I thought these were super cute, and you know, I mean, it's a great idea, and I thought everyone would like to make one. And so yeah. And so I put this here because this, you're not going to be able to see this much anyways because of, you know, it's going to be covered with the top that's going to fold over, okay? So you just put it there. There we go. Put it there. And yeah. And then I trimmed it here just in case it moved. And so that's my piece. So then what you're going to do next is you're going to take your glue and you're going to do the sides with the glue. Oh, I think I need a new glue. I have one. I'll get it in a second. Okay. And the same here. You just glue the side. Okay. And then what you're going to do is you're going to bring it back over. And you're going to bring it over and meet the top. Okay? Meet the top. Leave it a little shorter, just a tiny bit. Or bring it up. Whichever way you want to do it, it's fine with me. I did it even because I liked it the way it looked, but it's okay. Whichever way you want to do it, doesn't really matter. Because it's gonna, you're gonna see it, you know. You're going to be able to put your pencils in okay, and so then there's your opening right there, guys. And so you want to make sure that this one though, the inner, is even with the top of the backing. Okay, you want to make sure those two are even. Okay, so there's your pocket. Here's your pocket for your pencils, erasers, pen. Whichever way, whatever you want to use it for, it works for everything. It's such a good little idea. So give me a second here. I'm going to get my other glue. Is that glue? It's giving me a little headache. Hold on one second for me, guys. I apologize. Should have been ready, but my glue for some reason is acting up. Okay. So now what we're going to do is we're going to glue the hair. Okay? It's going to look like that. That's going to be your hair. Okay, guys? So basically, you're going to take your purple. And guys, again, you can do the hair any color you want. It doesn't have to be these colors. I use these colors because that's what the lady had used. And I thought it looked cute. And so, yeah. But it's not written in stone that you got to use these colors, okay, guys? So basically put a little glue again, and again, I love this glue because it tends to glue fast. You don't have to wait there for it to glue on your felt. Okay, come on. So basically what you're gonna do is you're gonna even out that right there, bring your curve up a little bit, and there you go. Then your pink one, you're gonna put it right here, okay guys? So you're gonna curve this pink a little bit, see? So it is curved perfectly on that edge. So let's go ahead and glue that puppy. Yeah, it's just a easy tutorial. I thought it'd be great, you know, with school starting and the little girls, they love to have all their cutesies, you know. I thought it was a great idea to do one and show you guys. And so let's see what I did here. And you know, okay, so I think I put that on wrong. There we go. Okay. So I'm not sure why this one is not facing up. Okay, so I did have it right. Sorry guys, the hair is very, very annoying a little bit because you kind of put it away and then you'll look at it and you'll say, I'm not sure if that's right, but it actually was. So then this little piece here is your little bang. And so what you're going to do with this little piece is you're going to put it here and you're going to lift the pink just a tiny bit, like to put it underneath it. Okay, kind of curve it in there a little bit. Very simple. And then there is your green part. Okay. And you don't have to worry, it doesn't have to be all the way up like I did this one. As you can see, it's still down and you don't have to worry about that. But if you want to make it a little higher, you can always do that, okay guys? But that's the way I received it and that's the way I did it, okay? So next, God, I got so much glue on my fingers. So next we're gonna do our eyelashes and we're going to glue them real quick. Just put a little bit here, dab there, dab there. This glue is so great, but it is so stringy sometimes. So yeah. So then you're just gonna put your eyelash down. Okay, and then you're gonna do your second one here. I hope you guys like this tutorial that I'm doing. I'm trying to do more tutorials and I come up with these ideas and then I see other people that do them before me and I'm like, I was just thinking about doing that, but that's the world of crafting. You have to, you know, doesn't matter who does it. It's just a good idea. And so, yeah. So now you put your cheeks here. Put your little cheeky cheeks. Little cheeky cheeky Dan, a little cheeky cheeky here. Okay. And then you're going to do your mouth. And guys, you don't have to do the pockets blue neither. You can do these whichever way you want. And now I just did it this way because that's the way that I saw and I kind of liked it. And yeah, and so that's what I did. Then what you can also do is like I did to this one. I did it and I found it a little, I want to shorten it up a little bit, which you can. Because see, this one looks a little longer, so I might have just cut it a little bit bigger. So, because I tried cutting it with my cutter and it wouldn't cut, so I'm just going to give it a little trim here to make it look a little bit smaller because I like it. It doesn't have to be that big for pencils. And then if it's, you know, if you cut it and you don't have the glue, don't worry about it. You can just put a little extra glue there and it will work. Okay, so there's your pocket, guys. Super cute, and I hope you like it. I mean, it's super easy. It's a great way to you know, make a little something for your kids for school, or you know, even for us, that we love our unicorns, right? So yeah, so I thought these were cute and they're easy to make. And again, I'll try to put the template down, and if I can, you guys can email me and I will send it to you, no problem. But yeah, guys, you can put all your little pencils and pen here. I got some pens here. Let's see. So yeah, so cutesy. Look at that. It's so amazing how you can fit a lot of stuff in that. So yeah, I thought they were cute and I wanted to share. Hopefully you like them and you'll make some. If you do, tag me so I can see your work. But I do thank the inspiration from Pinterest, and I'm glad that you took the time to watch my video. I appreciate you guys. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.